Hey, it's Brian Mudd. This is my cheat sheet for Monday, September 24th. How vulnerable is your PIN number? A whole lot more vulnerable than you probably thought. I mean, it is just four numbers, and in this computer age where people, you know, can hack things relatively easily, if somebody has access to your debit card, for example, hacking your PIN number can be a little more than them running information through a computer and trying a bunch of different things until they find one that works. But in many cases, they don't even have to do that. Get this. The average PIN number can be found 26% of the time within 20 tries. That means that if somebody were to steal or get a hold of your debit card, more than a quarter of the time, they could compromise you, compromise your accounts that are linked to that card number within 20 tries. And why? Because we're creatures of habit. We all ultimately have somewhat similar numbers that we identify with when we're told to choose four of them. Now, ultimately, even if you come up with a number that is more complicated than the average 1, 2, 3, 4, for example, which, by the way, there are a lot of people that do just use 1, 2, 3, 4, no joke, and many that also use just 1, 1, 1, 1, but that's beside the point. Ultimately, this gets back to why I think you need identity protection, because in the event that you do have a debit card compromised, the odds are that if somebody really wants to get your PIN number bad enough, they probably can, and it's just a matter of time. Free checking. Stay with the banking theme here. Do you have truly free checking? And if you do, if you're saying yes, you're now officially in the minority. One of the things talked about with more regulations as a result of the financial regulation reform, Dodd-Frank and such, that ended up getting passed is, while there are some things that are along the line of consumer protection and you might like, there are also plenty of things that are just more regulation and make it more difficult for the banks to do business, make money. And you know what that means. They pass it through to us. And so the age of free checking is officially no longer with us, not on average. Only 39% of checking accounts are truly free anymore. Now, there are some banks that are better than others, so it's not as though they're all the same. And a lot of it has to do with how much money or how many accounts and how long you've been doing business with a particular bank. But if you haven't been checking your bank notices throughout the course of this year, you probably should. There have been dramatic increases across all banking fee lines throughout the course of this year. And there's a possibility that you're paying fees and more in fees than you realized previously if you haven't been paying attention. I have some information on the physical cheat sheet about how you can go about obtaining a free checking account. It really is out there. You just have to be a little harder in your looking than you used to be. Update your Internet Explorer now. Last week had the information that there was a serious vulnerability in Internet Explorer browsers 7 through 9. And that if you fell victim to this, your computer could be compromised. They could hijack you. You know, the ill-doers on the other side could hijack your computer and use it as though they were you, which means, obviously, completely compromising your computer. So, Internet Explorer on Friday did get the patch, did get the update, so you need to update it now if you haven't already. And again, that's Internet Explorer users 7 through 9. And the link to get the patch is on my physical cheat sheet today. And the iPhone 5. There are one of the things, by the way, mine was actually waiting for me when I got home on Friday, which was a bit of a pleasant surprise. The iPhone 5, one of the big criticisms of it, you have to buy new accessories if you're a previous iPhone user in order to use your iPhone 5. And it does come with one adapter that you can plug in to a computer, plug in to a power outlet just to charge your phone. But everything else you have, including docking stations and the like, none of it's any good anymore once you go to the iPhone 5 and you have to buy all new accessories. In fact, there's an estimate that the average iPhone 5 purchaser will spend more than $100 on new accessories just to replace the stuff they can no longer use. Or you can do this. You just purchase one accessory. Now, I know it sounds a little bit odd to say, hey, you can make use of more accessories if you just buy one more accessory. But there's a lightning adapter that's coming out that'll plug into your iPhone 5 that will allow you to use the previous size accessories for the iPhone. So if you don't want to get rid of all the old ones, it's the lightning adapter that you should look for that'll plug right into it and make them all work. All right, that's the cheat sheet for today. Enjoy yours. We'll see you tomorrow.